You're gonna think I'm crazy, but I just quit my job as executive producer of video at Sports Illustrated to play poker.
Be a judgment.
How did I get to this point? It has to deal with a high-stakes poker game, Phil Hellmuth, and of course, pocket jacks. Let's go back in time a little bit.
I need to make a withdrawal of 20,000.
A little bit more than that.
Is Ace-King the most overplayed hand in poker?
Even more than that. Keep going. Wait, stop. Ooh, way too far. Senior year, Shakopee, Minnesota, Mystic Lake Casino, I fall in love with blackjack. I also fall in love with video making. I end up going to college for video, get a job at the NFL Network out in Los Angeles. I move out there, go to Hollywood Park Casino, and fall in love with poker. Over the next few years, I worked my way up in the sports industry, which is really the dream that I thought I wanted. However, as you move up the ladder in a company, you stop being creative. You start dealing with schedules. You start dealing with people management. You start dealing with layoffs. Meanwhile, on the side, I had started my own TikTok account where I just posted funny videos about poker, casino content in general, and one video took off.
That's disgusting. Damn, so how'd you get back home? You had the Uber?
What you mean, my boy?
The Pocket Jacks video. Overnight, my following went from 10 people to 10,000 people, and that's when I changed my name to the Casino King. As my following grew, I stumbled upon Phil Hellmuth's email address, so I decided to take a shot. I sent him a cold email, asked if I could interview him, and somehow, out of his busy schedule, not knowing me, Phil Hellmuth replied, "Yes. Can you meet me in Minnesota?" Spoiler alert, I live in Minnesota.
Who are we playing? The legend himself.
Phil fucking Hellmuth, that's who.
Those clips took off, and all of a sudden, I could see the light at the end of the tunnel. I could see my life starting to change. After the Phil Hellmuth interview, I wanted to know what was next. And that's when all of a sudden it hit me, the best person to ask would be Eric Person, at the time, Phil Hellmuth's biggest rival. I DM'd him on Instagram, and to my surprise, he got right back to me and said, "Yes, meet me in Vegas." So I fly out to Vegas, hit a slot machine right when I land, and then I played some poker that night. And that was the first time I ever vlogged my poker hands. And I got crushed. I didn't even want to post any of the videos. And a little voice in my head said, "Make a sarcastic video with your vlogs."
How to play pocket jacks flawlessly. It's actually pretty simple. Every time the action gets to you, go ahead and fold it.
That video got millions of views across all platforms, and I realized I cracked the code on what my content was gonna be. It was gonna be the "I am the most relatable person in the room" content, and that gets millions of views. And that's when my buddy Yuri hit me up and mentioned the creator game on Hustler Casino Live. I messaged Ryan Feldman asking if there was a chance that I could play in the creator game, and he said, "No. But if you wanna play on a different game, we'd love to have you." I asked him what the blinds are. He said 10, 20, 40.
I was calling because I need to make a withdrawal of 20,000.
Yeah. Can I put you on hold for 1 second? Intermittent.
I thought winning money would be the toughest part of this, but actually getting the money for the game has been the toughest.
The phone call with the bank actually went better than my first conversation with my wife, telling her that I needed to take $20,000 out of our bank account, fly to Los Angeles, and gamble with it. But after some conversations, it actually turned out that she wanted to come with me and bring our one-year-old son. When I got to the airport, I realized the stakes have never been higher. We landed in LA, we got to the Airbnb I was supposed to play that night. We got everything unpacked, I hit the road and realized I was getting crushed by LA traffic and was gonna be late.
On the way to the casino, but LA traffic is fucking me up, man.
Sweat just dripping down as I realized I was about to botch this opportunity. Luckily, other players were running late and the stream got pushed to start a half hour later. That gave me enough time to get my chips out of the Hustler Casino bank where I wired the money to, sit down, and get adjusted. At my table is Wesley, who everybody knows from losing the biggest pot in the history of live streaming, absolute legend. I had Israeli Ron, and right to my right is Nick Vertucci, legend himself. I'm gonna make a full video on that entire night, but it was insane. I have never ran as good as I did that night in the highest stakes that I've ever even thought about playing. I bought in for $10,000, cashed out for over $30,000, a $20,000 profit. My mind was absolutely blown. The next morning, Nick hit me up and said, hey, will you come down and join the podcast? I went and talked to him and Veronica.
What is the most degen thing you've done or seen?
After I left that, I decided I'm quitting my job. I'm doing this full time. So what's next for me? Well, I'm all on my own right now, and I'm so excited to be. I'm heading out to the World Series of Poker for the first time. I'm gonna play in some cash games, I'm gonna play in some tournaments, and I'm gonna try to play in some live streams as well. All of it is gonna be documented on my YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram pages. This is not your average poker account. It never will be. For all of you that have supported me through my sports media career and are now seeing this for the first time, I appreciate your support. I hope that this content also is something you're interested in. This is just the beginning for me, even though I'm kind of all in already.